concern, but there is certainly a lot about global warming and green technology and keeping our rivers and you know, flowing and keeping our rivers clean and protecting our environment all the way around. We have a lot of work to put into that.
Definitely.
Okay, appreciate you. Thanks for calling.
Yeah. All right.
Congresswoman, we are going to go to Marissa in Roanoke Park. She is an administrator with a question about the future of America.
Hello, Melissa. Thank you for calling me.
Thank you.
Something.
I am 14, and I had the opportunity to meet you last summer, actually, in your office. That was wonderful. And I was just curious about what can my age group do right now to make a difference and to help our future?
Well, first of all, you're doing it by being interested in your country and in your government. And that's a huge step forward. The other step is by being in school and being a good student, and which will mean you'll be part of of this country, and that's so important to us. But the kinds of things you're
all right, okay, here, just the deal. So, I guess this phone call from the congresswoman to be part of this town hall meeting. My question is, how come the stimulus package does not give any real money to the Americans so we can choose and pick which businesses we want to succeed or fail? In other words, if I was to open up a business and it was to fail, I would be allowed to fail. Shouldn't the banks be allowed to fail, thus exonerating the debt of the people? Let's see if I get to ask my question.
There's a lot of big things that could happen if we don't become much smarter. You're smarter than I am already, and just keep being that smart kid, and have opinions, and help be a leader, and help people know that we have to live differently in order to live well in the future.
All right, thank you so much. That means a lot to me.
Well, Melissa, thank you, and it's nice to talk to you, and I'm glad you had a good time when you were in Washington, D.C.
I did. Thank you so much for your time.
You're welcome.
Bye.
Goodbye.
Okay, Congresswoman, we've got time for one more question, and we have Harriet from Santa Rosa on the line.
I didn't hear the name of...
I'm sorry, Harriet?
Harriet
from Santa Rosa has a question about Afghanistan.
Hi, Harriet.
Hello, hi.
Hi.
I think this is a great idea what you're doing.
Oh, I'm glad you stayed on the line.
Pardon me?
Thank you for staying on the line.
Oh, you're welcome. My question is, I read an article in the paper that said that the oversight for Afghanistan, the troops are sending and the weapons and everything, it's the same as it was for Iraq. This the story said that there was not any.
Your vote has been registered. Very troubled.
Well, I mean, why should we be surprised? I mean, it's the same oversight that the last administration and President Bush put in place, which was terribly lacking, and it would be both in Iraq and Afghanistan. But it will change.
It will.
President Obama has been in office less than a month, and he, believe me, he can't do everything we want him to do here today. And I'm just as concerned as to be about Afghanistan, and have written the president a letter. I wrote him a letter on Inauguration Day, always say if you have a party and have a good time, then you can, everybody else must have had somewhat of a good time.
You didn't answer my question.
I hope you did.
Senator.
And I hope this proved to be informative and enjoyable experience for you.
Senator.
And I particularly want to thank everyone who asked some great, great questions tonight.
You didn't answer my question.
While apologizing to those of you who were hoping to ask, who stayed on the line, who didn't get through.
You're damn right.
But I do want to hear from you. So if you're waiting to ask a question, please stay on the line. Leave me a voicemail with your question, or leave me your phone number, and we can get back to you, and we will follow up with you soon. So I want to remind you to sign up for my electronic newsletter, which will keep you up to date on what's happening here in Washington. You can sign up for it by visiting my website, www.wolfie.house.gov. Thank you so much. This has been so much fun. Bye now.
You didn't answer my question. You didn't. Well, hang up, Wolfie.
Hi, this is Lynn Wolfie. Thanks for joining me tonight. I'm sorry that I was unable to get to your question. I do want to know what's on your mind, so please leave me a voicemail after the meeting. Also, if you're interested in receiving updates on what's happening in Washington, please let me have your email address or your phone number. Thanks again. I'm sorry we missed.
My name is The Real AIX from YouTube. I also live in Sonoma County. I'd love to interview you for my YouTube show.
Goodbye.
Goodbye.